in over 100 countries, in 7 different languages, to more than a half billion viewers each week. The World Wrestling Federation, the worldwide leader in sports entertainment.
It's gotten out of control, though, lately. We've seen some real unnecessary injuries, I think, happen, namely to Ahmed Johnson because of this factional warfare. And Commissioner Slaughter has begun to lay down the law on, you know, ancillary members of these factions being at ringside for a singles match like this. I'll be interested to see if these other men are allowed to maintain their position here at ringside when this singles match gets underway.
Referee Earl Hebner will have to assert himself here. And it might be judicious to not allow these other faction members to remain at ringside. It's certainly a volatile situation.
Listen to this crowd.
Very uncomplimentary chant.
Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Well, the referee has informed me that members that are not wrestling of the Nation of Domination and Los Boricuas must return to the dressing room.
Well, that may not make 6 people very happy, but I think it's going to make for a better one-on-one contest for these athletes that are not directly involved in this match, specifically Salvio Vega and D'Lo Brown, head back to the locker room. Of course, folks, it's been a blockbuster week in the WWF. Many of you are aware of the news regarding Stone Cold Steve Austin. The situation made by Commissioner Slaughter was that Stone Cold Steve Austin, because of his neck injury at the hands of Owen Hart, Austin will not be allowed to compete tomorrow night on pay-per-view during the Fatal 4-Way. As a result of that decision, Dude Love will not compete either because of his loyalty to Stone Cold. And now the Headbangers will have an opportunity to compete in the Fatal 4-Way for the WWF Tag Team Championship. We'll have more on that and footage. I mean, some wild footage from deep in the heart of Texas from Stone Cold Steve Austin later here on the broadcast. Hard shoulder block by Savio Vega on D'Lo Brown. And one thing's for sure, Savio Vega, the right hand. Savio has a great experience advantage here, Kevin. However, let's not underestimate the athletic ability of young D'Lo Brown.
Remember when Farouk gave Savio Vega and Crush their papers out of the Nation of Domination? He kept D'Lo Brown. I think he kept him for a reason, JR. He sees something in this man. This man is a fantastic athlete, along with now Rocky Maivia and Kama Mustafa, the Nation of Domination, more powerful than ever.
D'Lo Brown, a very intelligent individual, a college graduate. a certified public accountant.
Would you let him do your taxes?
Well, I don't know if I do that or not. I think he does Cornette's taxes. That's another issue. And certainly as we talk about Ground Zero, let's make one thing perfectly clear, folks. The event is tomorrow night on pay-per-view. But bottom line, as Stone Cold would say, the Rattlesnake will be at Ground Zero. We'll have more on that good arm drag takeover.
Jim, the one match I'm thinking about, I can't get out of my mind, I can't wait to see, is The Undertaker battling Shawn Michaels. I mean, you've got two of the most powerful forces ever in World Wrestling Federation history colliding for the first time, and it all happens tomorrow night, folks, at Ground Zero. I know I can't wait.
Back elbow by D'Lo Brown on the break.
Ooh.
And a hard knife-edge chop on the chest of Savio Vega. And you can hear the impact of those stinging blows, and Savio turns the table.
Oh!
And you can hear the impact and the aggression of the man from South Bronx, and D'Lo Brown wants to distance himself from the fiery Savio Vega. Savio with a spinning heel kick on D'Lo Brown, and not only will Savio Vega be involved in that big triple threat matchup tomorrow night on pay-per-view at Ground Zero, look out.
Watch out.
Savio crushed at Farouk, and Savio with a suicide-like dive off the top, and that's from a 260-pound man.
Incredible agility there from Savio Vega, but imagine what it must feel like for Savio and Crush in the triple threat match in there with a former boss.
Boy, it's going to be an emotional, physical night. Look at this move. Savio Vega absolutely taking every chance in a book here. And Savio may have hurt his knee. Savio Vega now may have hurt his knee, Kevin, on that high-risk maneuver, and D'Lo Brown's taking advantage.
This is where D'Lo's going to put Farouk's plan into attack. He's going to try to eliminate Savio even before Ground Zero.
Savio Vega has a huge challenge awaiting him at Ground Zero. He's in trouble. We're right back.
The first incident was perhaps an accident.
This is horrible.
But the second assault was a monumental mistake. Because now there's hell to pay. There will be no mercy. There will be no remorse. Shawn Michaels.
You expect me to cower down? Do you know who I am?
The Undertaker.
I will possess your soul.
Their first meeting ever. Strydex presents WWF Round Zero in your house. Live tomorrow on pay-per-view.
Welcome back, everybody, to WWF New York. Savio Vega during the break, mounted some offense. Savio with the advantage, lateral press, and a near fall.
And Jim, of course, the other members of these factions have been sent back to the locker room, courtesy of referee Earl Hebner, and a good decision, I would say.
High back body drop by Savio Vega, the man from South Bronx. Building some momentum here on young D'Lo Brown of the Nation of Domination.
Wait a second. Wait.
Wait, hey, ref. Look out.
Where did he come from?
A powerbomb by Miguel Perez of Los Barriquas apparently came through the crowd and over the rail. Savio has the referee distracted. And now Savio Vega drops the elbow. It's formality. And Savio Vega and Los Barriquas, by any means necessary, if you will, win this matchup.
That's not going to sit well with Farouk and the other members of the Nation of Domination, but it looks like Los Barriquas pulled one over.
Here comes Rocky Maivia and the rest of the Nation of Domination. But too little, too late.
And Jim, I understand our cameras picked up exactly where Miguel Perez came from. Just like you said, out of the crowd and over the railing with the referee's attention diverted. That's what led Savio to the win. You got to wonder who's going to have the best game plan tomorrow night at Ground Zero.
Well, folks, as you know now, Stone Cold. Welcome back this morning to WWF New York. Tomorrow night's WWF Ground Zero is presented by Strydex. Triple clean your skin with Strydex medicated pads.
And what an awesome World Wrestling Federation title match we can expect from both Bret the Hitman Hart, the champion, and the Red Hot Patriot. There's no secret, both athletes have focused a lot of aggression on one another, especially after what happened last night. Right now, let's take you to Friday night's main event and see Bret's little brother battle this man, the Patriot.
Here comes the Patriot on his way to the ring to take on Owen Hart. And of course, the Patriots' meteoric rise up the ladder here at the World Wrestling Federation has been nothing short of astounding. Let's take you back to last Friday night. Bret Hart beating Vader. Bret trying to break Vader's leg, and the Patriot once again gets involved in Bret Hart's business. This Sunday on pay-per-view, it will be the Patriot and Canada's proudest son meeting for the WWF title at Ground Zero. Not to mention this Monday, the Patriot will be involved on Raw in a big triple threat matchup. So a very busy period of time for the Patriot. Carrying the make-believe to the ring. And Doc, this match has got a lot of underlying tones to it, in my estimation. We've got Owen Hart, who is going to be the last roadblock for the Patriot before the Patriot challenges Bret Hart, Owen's brother, for the WWF title at Ground Zero. So I've got to wonder just exactly what Owen's true motivation here might be.
Well, I tell you, JR, if you're asking me, I'll tell you, I think that Owen Hart probably wants to slap that sharpshooter on the Patriot and hold it and try to injure him for this big WWF Championship match this Sunday. But it could be a double-edged sword. Uh-oh, here we go in the flag contest. Because if Owen is not careful enough, the Patriot could end up weakening Owen for the first ever fatal four-way WWF Tag Team title match.
Owen Hart not getting a very positive response from these fans here in the United States. And certainly this young man, the youngest of the 12 children of Stu and Helen Hart of Calgary, Alberta, Canada. One of the, in my estimation, Doc, one of the most underrated competitors in the long history of the WWF. And, of course, a great ovation, as one would expect, for Old Glory here. Owen Hart first entered the WWF. Wrestled under a mask as the Blue Blazer. And this should be a most interesting contest. Will Owen Hart be looking for a victory, or will Owen Hart be looking to injure the Patriot before the Patriot challenges Bret Hart for the WWF title?
And you know, JR, from the Patriot's perspective, do you think that he feels competing against Owen right here really gets him ready for Bret, because there's so many similarities between Owen and Bret?
Well, both Bret and Owen are very, very sound fundamentally. They're outstanding athletes. So I think, yes, I would want to call this a tune-up match, but what a great opportunity for the Patriot here to continue to build momentum as well. Side headlock by Owen Hart. And Owen Hart the quicker of the two here, but the Patriot takes Owen up and over. And we're seeing the power of the 6'5", 275-pound Patriot here in the early going.
One thing the Patriot is going to have to look out for is Owen Hart's feet. He's very adept at using his feet as well as his hands. I mean, his whole body's like a lethal weapon inside of that ring.
Owen Hart with an outstanding amateur background, the youngest of the 12 of the Hart children of Stu and Helen Hart of Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Owen Hart certainly has the ability to turn a disadvantage into an advantage. There's the elbow by the former Intercontinental Champion, drop toe hold. So the Patriot now with the arm. Right now the Patriot is controlling the tempo here, which will bode well perhaps for this big man from South Carolina, former outstanding football player in college for the University of South Carolina. And Owen Hart steps away from the break and returns a couple of right hands. And Owen, Doc, a little overzealous this time. And he pays for that mistake by this big man from Columbia, South Carolina.
And I'll tell you what, if Owen Hart is not careful here, you let the Patriot get that enthusiasm, that momentum going, he's hard to stop, like a fast break team in basketball.
I know our great fans in Canada, but we will be watching Ground Zero. It is this Sunday from Louisville, Kentucky. And there is a lateral press by the Patriot. And Owen Hart really getting worn down here by his larger opponent. Owen weighing in at 227. The Patriot almost 50 pounds larger. And Owen with a back heel kick. Nice spinning kick by Owen Hart in this. Doc, you pointed out you've got to watch everything from Owen Hart, especially his feet.
Owen is phenomenal. Of course, known very well for the British Bulldog and himself being two-time WWF Tag Champions. Let's not forget, it wasn't about three, 4 weeks ago, Owen was the Intercontinental Champion.
Owen Hart now trying to destroy the vertical base to eliminate the leverage advantage of his taller opponent by working and focusing on that knee. And certainly that would also be a prelude, perhaps, Doc, as you mentioned earlier. Oh, backbreaker to the sharpshooter.
Very sound fundamental attack here by Owen Hart. He's keeping that fire, that enthusiasm that the Patriot has. He's keeping it to a minimal right now.
Owen Hart now, who debuted in 1986 up on the second rope, and finds the mark with the elbow. Will that be enough? The leg is hooked, and great technique by Owen Hart. Certainly coming up within a one count of winning this matchup. And now it looks as if Doc Owen may be shifting his focus to the back of the Patriot. We've got a spirited affair here, folks. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Welcome back, everybody, to WWF New York. Right now, we'll take you back to the exciting conclusion of last night's match between Owen Hart and the Patriot. And once again, we will learn that the Hart Foundation enjoys running in a pack. And more importantly, I think, will do anything they can to keep Bret Hart securely as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
And Owen Hart climbing to the top of the ladder. Owen Hart would love to put the Patriot out of action. And that drop kick will not do the masked man any favors. There's a lateral press. The leg hooked, and we got a 2.5 count.
J.R. Owen Hart has done a remarkable job of taking the crowd out of this ball game, so to speak. He has been relentless on his attack. Oh, here we go.
Owen Hart looking for the sharpshooter here. And indeed, well, the Patriot able to counter that. Owen Hart could never get it applied. And right now, we know the Patriot defeated Bret Hart on July 28th before Bret became WWF Champion. Power slam. At SummerSlam, we know that the Patriot has defeated the British Bulldog in one-on-one competition. So Owen Hart is next on the list as this masked man continues to build momentum. And right now, the Southpaw Doc, he's finding his mark for those big lefts.
Oh!
What a drop kick.
You talk about athleticism. Here's a guy, 6'4". 260, 270 pounds, nailing Owen Hart, who's what, 6'1", 6'2", right in the noggin with a drop kick.
Owen Hart face first into the top turnbuckle. And another hard Irish whip and a clothesline. And now you see the size advantage of the Patriot being factored into the equation here. It's going to be a great matchup, great suplex. And there's a cover. And another near fall, Owen Hart. This time, just easing that left shoulder off the canvas. You got to know that Bret the Hitman Hart, who is in the arena, I'll talk to him later tonight, is watching this matchup. Owen Hart with the enziguri.
Man, did he nail that one, JR.
Owen Hart struck gold with the enziguri. Now, Owen Hart, take what? He took a little bit too much time, apparently, going to the top. And the Patriot with a hard slam. Slam, wait a minute, there's a British Bulldog.
Here we go.
The brother-in-law of Owen Hart, the British Bulldog, interrupting this matchup. And here comes Bret Hart. Here comes the WWF champion. And now it's an opportunity for 3-on-1. Three of the Hart Foundation, the DDT, to dismantle the Patriot.
Bret just planted the Patriot with that DDT. Well, I don't like the Patriots' chances here at all, JR.
We saw this 3-on-1 attack to Vader last week, right here on Raw, and the Patriot was right on the scene to interject himself, and now the Patriot, maybe just moments away from being unable to compete. Wait a minute. Here comes Vader. Doc, it's
what?
Vader.
It's Vader.
Vader. Vader bear hugging the bulldog and ramming the bulldog right back into Owen Hart. And Bret Hart with a sharpshooter, and here comes Vader. Vader has not forgotten what the Hart Foundation attempted to do to him.
And look at those shots.
Vader now showing some teamwork. Oh, look out! Look out!
Oh.
Bret Hart now being taken apart by the Patriot with some help by Vader. But what's going on between Vader and the Patriot? And what shape is Bret Hart in?
Man, did the Patriot nail him with the Uncle Slam. If he does that this Sunday, we might have a brand new WWF champion.
The result of a disqualification, the Patriots.
Well, it's hard to believe that the Patriot and Vader are almost fighting side by side.
Well, you can look at that look, JR. They're not the best of friends, but they have one thing in common. That's Bret Hart.
Well, Kevin, last night on Friday night's main event, The Undertaker once again would meet with some huge challenges.
It had the opportunity to really stack the odds against The Undertaker. The deck would be stacked, but which card would be turned over? Could it be that Lady China? Or what about the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels? Or maybe even Ravishing Rick Rude? Let's take you to the contest and you'll see exactly how it unfolds.
And here comes the 1997 King of the Ring, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, with his 200-pound queen, China. Don't forget, this Monday on Raw, Hunter Hearst Helmsley will be involved in a tremendous triple threat matchup that we understand will feature Mr. Helmsley, the Patriot, who could be the new WWF champion by Monday, and the European champion, the British Bulldog. That triple threat action when Raw returns this Monday, live from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Shawn Michaels is back in the locker room area, and if he sees the opportunity, he's going to take it. Shawn Michaels is a very intelligent man, whether people like him or not. He knows where to pick his spots.
The unearthly presence of the greatest phenom in the World Wrestling Federation since the late Andre the Giant. The 6'10 and one half, 325-pound Undertaker, the former WWF champion, has a date with destiny when The Undertaker meets Shawn Michaels this Sunday at Ground Zero. What a phenomenal event that is shaping up to be. But right here tonight, will Hunter Hearst Helmsley pay for the sins of Shawn Michaels?
Do you think The Undertaker's been somewhat shocked, surprised at the way Shawn Michaels has been bringing this attack to him?
Well, perhaps. He could be pretty tough when he got a weapon. I got a feeling are just getting started here as far as this match is concerned. China seems to be wanting to give The Undertaker a wide berth. That shows her wisdom, Doc.
Shows a lot of wisdom. And now you have to wonder, what kind of game plan does Hunter Hearst Helmsley have here? You've got to be cautious with the phenom, but if you don't bring the fight to him, he's going to eat you up.
Helmsley must be quick. Helmsley must use technique and leverage to survive this, maybe to hit and run, and Helmsley striking quickly and suddenly with right hands on the uh-oh.
See, that's the problem.
The Undertaker just overpowering Helmsley. Big time right hand. Ooh. And another right hand by the former WWF champion. Hard Irish whip in, and again a power display. And the Undertaker, well, this referee is keeping his distance.
Can you blame him?
Heck no. Hard close on Helmsley, up and over. Well, as Doc mentioned, we know Shawn Michaels is here. We know that the insurance man, Ravishing Rick Rude, is here. Just gotta wonder what could be in store as this match progresses for the Undertaker. Or are we reading too much into it, Doc?
I don't know. I just don't think so. But I think that was a mistake by the Undertaker going out to the floor. And now here comes Helmsley to capitalize.
Helmsley with a whip. And the Undertaker again able to overpower Helmsley, who had lowered his head. And it may be chokeslam time. And look who's coming.
The premium's paid up.
Yeah, I'm pretty heavily insured.
Whoa!
Helmsley thrown right out here in front of us. The insurance man Ravishing Rick Rude. And you gotta wonder, who's paying Rude's bill tonight? And Helmsley from behind, is it Helmsley? Is it China? Could it be Shawn Michaels? Or is it somebody else?
Welcome back, everyone. We'll take you back to action from last night as the Undertaker battled Hunter Hearst Helmsley. Rick Rude was at ringside. You'd have to wonder, how long would it be before the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels would make an appearance? We wouldn't have to wait very long.
Reversal of the whip. And nice move by Helmsley. Helmsley is a tremendous tactician. One of the most cerebral athletes in the WWF. Very, very high IQ. Extremely intelligent grappler. And now Helmsley taking a chance that did pay off. Will that be enough? One, two, and no.
Well, Mr. Cerebral should know you've got to hook the leg with the Undertaker.
Ravishing Rick Rude getting a close look. And you, oh my, right hand. I just don't have a peaceful, easy feeling with Rick Rude here at ringside as it relates to the Undertaker. Hard whip, and the Undertaker meets Helmsley coming in. No matter what Helmsley tries to do to the Undertaker is relentless, Doc, and just keeps coming back, retaliating, and absorbing all that punishment. Oh, look at the elevation.
Man, where does he come up with these things? I mean, the athleticism is unbelievable.
Helmsley quickened the pace. And the Undertaker stayed with Helmsley step by step. Man, what a matchup this Sunday at Ground Zero. What an event. Ground Zero is going to be. It is this Sunday. It's from the sold-out Louisville Gardens in Louisville, Kentucky, in the bluegrass country of the United States. The Undertaker and Shawn Michaels.
Here we go, up the ladder to the roof, the stairway to heaven.
What balance from this giant. What athleticism from this phenom. And a tremendous leg drop by the Undertaker. That could be all. One, two, and Helmsley able to get a shoulder up. And look at Rick Rude sneaking up on the apron, trying on the other side. And Rude is nabbed. But when Shawn Michaels is coming in.
I knew it.
Michaels just hit the Undertaker in the knee. And now there's three men on one. And China assaults the referee.
Oh, she's got the chair.
China with that same chair that Shawn Michaels used to bust the Undertaker's head open. And now China is holding these officials at bay. Oh, come on. The Undertaker has been busted open from ear to ear by Shawn Michaels. And now look at this heinous attack.
Looks like bottom of the ninth. 3-2 count.
The Undertaker broke free. And when it's one-on-one, Shawn Michaels wants nothing to do with the man from the dark side. Uh-oh, look out. Wait a minute. No, no.
That's going to cost him.
WWF official Jared Briscoe just got chokeslammed. And another security guard. Chokeslammed out and in. The Undertaker is striking anything and anybody that moves. And now he means business. And look at brave Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels with insurance. Shawn Michaels with a steel chair. But Shawn Michaels sure doesn't want to go one-on-one right now with The Undertaker. That's carnage. And what's going to happen at Ground Zero?
Well, folks, we'll find out tomorrow night on pay-per-view what an event it's going to be. It's easy to order pay-per-view. Don't forget that. And light heavyweights are going to be in action. Brian Christopher will go one-on-one with Scott Putski.
Talk about disgruntled employees. The original members of the Nation of Domination will battle it out triple threat style. Farouk versus Savio Vega versus Crush. It's factional warfare at its best.
And in the fatal four-way matchup, Stone Cold and Dude Love are out. The Headbangers are in, and we will crown, without a doubt, new tag team champions tomorrow night on pay-per-view.
It's a very tense Dustin Runnels household right now, as Marlena could be Brian Pillman's for 30 days and 30 nights. Who will win as Goldust battles Brian Pillman with so much on the line at Ground Zero?
And for the first time ever, one-on-one, Shawn Michaels meets the awesome Undertaker. Ladies and gentlemen, who can predict what's going to happen when the Giant Killer Shawn Michaels faces the most indestructible force in the WWF, The Undertaker?
The World Wrestling Federation title is on the line as the five-time champion Bret the Hitman Hart defends against the Red Hot Patriot. It'll be the United States against Canada, but so much more at Ground Zero.
And it's all on pay-per-view tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. Whatever you do, order this tremendous pay-per-view, Ground Zero. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Jim Ross. So long, everybody. Steve Casey to take on Jerry Lynn in light heavyweight competition here on WWF New York. And certainly, it won't get any hotter. It won't be any more of an exciting atmosphere anywhere in the world than it will be in Madison Square Garden on Monday night, September the 22nd. Again, folks, don't miss your opportunity to be a part of history in the making. Be with us live at Madison Square Garden just a little over 2 weeks away. And Steve Casey, who hails from Cincinnati, Ohio, as a matter of fact, that's where Raw will emanate from this Monday night, taking on Jerry Lynn. And Jerry Lynn, we saw him, Kevin, for the first time a week or so ago on Friday night's main event, taking on Taka Michinoku, and he is a great athlete.
As is Steve Casey, Jim. These young men are both very impressive, and as the list of impressive athletes continues to grow within the light heavyweight division, it gets better and better every week.
The pace quickens here, as you would expect, between these athletes. Superb condition. Quickness and speed are their forte, along with their technique. And a nice drop kick by Jerry Lynn. Light heavyweights in action tomorrow night on pay-per-view as well. And Lynn up on top. And Lynn with a dive. Well, I'll tell you what, as a rule, Kevin, these light heavyweights seem to be fearless.
They certainly are, and you look at the matchup coming to Ground Zero with Brian Christopher and Scott Putski. There's more than just light heavyweight rankings in mind. That's a very personal issue having to do with family and heritage and tradition and a definite lack of respect as far as Brian Christopher and dear old daddy Jerry Lawler are concerned.
But that story at Ground Zero revolves around a couple of main storylines. One, the first time ever that The Undertaker will meet Shawn Michaels. Nice show of strength there by Steve Casey. And what role will Stone Cold Steve Austin play tomorrow night on pay-per-view? Austin has guaranteed us all that he will be at Ground Zero. Good move by Jerry Lynn. And I believe it because Stone Cold said so. That's a good move there. And a pinning combination. Crucifix there by Casey. Casey trained by another outstanding junior heavyweight in his day, Les Thatcher, who still resides down in Cincinnati. Again, Cincinnati, the home for Raw this Monday. And somewhat of a tactical move there, Kevin, by Jerry Lynn.
A mistake indeed, and now...
Oh, hello! DDT! Man, that was sudden.
What power! We talked about the high risk and the mobility, but you look at a power move like by Jerry Lynn there, devastating right in the corner. The DDT led to the win.
Light heavyweights in action tomorrow night on pay-per-view. But ladies and gentlemen, when WWF New York returns,
number 100.
Welcome to Shotgun, Michael Cole, along with Kevin Kelly. What a show we have for you this week.
The following six-man tag team match is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Approaching the ring, led by the Commandant from South Africa, at a total combined weight of 923 pounds, the Root Commission.
Look at this team, Kevin. We've seen them in weeks past. The Truth Commission, undefeated so far in the World Wrestling Federation.
And they are certainly beginning to make some waves in the tag team scene of the World Wrestling Federation. We saw the Interrogator dominate recently, and I know that Recon and Sniper are being put through their paces daily by the Commandant, who you see walking around as he inspects the troops before sending them into battle. They are an organized, disciplined, strong, big team. They have everything it takes, and I know we have new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. If I'm the Headbangers, I'm checking out the Truth Commission. Truth Commission set for a matchup here this week. Six-man matchup against Brian Taylor, Matt Duvall, and Brett Keane. The Interrogator, you saw there for a moment, goes 7 foot 350 pounds. There's also Sniper at 6 foot 5, and Recon goes 6 foot six, close to 300. He'll start things off for the Truth Commission. And there's the Commandant yelling at the crowd.
Part of their organization, part of their skill is the fact that Recon always begins their matches. He's the first one out. Sniper then comes in second, and usually the Interrogator comes in last to put the finishing touches on what has been many dominating wins in the World Wrestling Federation.
And here's Recon now working on Brett Keane. What a broadcast this week. We'll have more information on the Brian Pillman situation. Of course, Marlena Goldust's wife is Pillman's personal assistant. Pillman getting Marlena's services after beating Goldust at WWF Ground Zero in Louisville. Pillman is out of control. And can you imagine what Goldust must be going through?
But I'll tell you what, you want to talk about somebody out of control, somebody sick that's lost his mind. Stone Cold Steve Austin, I think, has finally gone over the edge. We'll document the entire situation, taking you through Ground Zero all the way to this past week on Raw, where it looked for a moment, Michael Cole, that our boss, Vince McMahon, was going to be on the receiving end of a Stone Cold Stunner.
And Matt Duvall now in the ring working against a Sniper from the Truth Commission. No contest here thus far. And I'll tell you what a tag team matchup. A bit later on in Shotgun, the LOD against Farouk and Kama from the Nation. That should be a collision. Sniper now in control of this matchup. He is the smallest of the three-member Truth Commission. He goes 6'5", but he is built. He's really in shape. I'll tell you what, this Commandant has this Truth Commission working at all levels, at all gears. Oh, Sniper there missed with the big elbow. Matt Duvall rolling out of the way and now trying to gain some momentum for his team. Duvall hammering away. Little drop kick knocks Sniper back into the rope. Very little. Irish whip now into the turnbuckle. Here comes Duvall, but catches the boot by Sniper. Sniper now off the ropes from the Truth Commission. Ooh, what a takedown. Duvall in trouble in the middle of the ring. Tell you what action at Ground Zero this past Sunday. And as you mentioned before, Kevin, new tag team champions in the World Wrestling Federation, the Headbangers. Here we go. The Interrogator lifts Taylor up, slams him to the canvas. This will be it. 2 and 3, it's all over. The Truth Commission victorious over Taylor, Duvall, and Keane.
A military mission carried out with expertise and skill. The Headbangers had better watch out. The Truth Commission are on their way.
The Truth Commission victorious on Shotgun. Let's take you to my colleague now, Todd Pettengill.
Hi, everybody. It's Todd Pettengill with an update on the latest World Wrestling Federation news. I'm sure you've all heard about it by now, but as a result of Stone Cold Steve Austin's injury at SummerSlam and his subsequent forfeiture of the tag team belt this past week at Ground Zero in your house, this superstar has gone off the deep end. He could not control himself during the fatal four-way matchup and made sure that Owen Hart and the British Bulldog would not regain the tag team belts. So, we have new champions. Mosh and Thrasher, the Headbangers. And the news is still rocking fans from Seattle to Manchester. Now, you can bet they will do everything possible to remain tag team champions when they square off against Savio and Miguel of Los Pericuas at Birmingham NEC in just 1 week, Saturday, September the 20th at 8 p.m. for one night only. You can see all the action for the very first time ever on pay-per-view, exclusively live on Sky Box Office. For further information, contact the Sky Box Office information line at 0990-800-888. Now, this past week on WWF Raw, Shawn Michaels committed a shameful act on the British Bulldog by trying to injure Davey Boy Smith while he made his way to the squared circle, evidently trying to soften up the Bulldog prior to their matchup at One Night Only. This rivalry has been developing over the years, and these two superstars have quite a history. They will be intense emotions and action swirling around the European title match next week at One Night Only. Now, most of you were expecting to see Shawn Michaels at the Birmingham City Center last week, but due to the recent events in the UK, his appearance was postponed, and we'd like to apologize to any fans who were inconvenienced. I can tell you now that not only is Shawn Michaels scheduled to appear at the City Center next week, but his opponent, your very own British Bulldog, will be there as well, face-to-face with Shawn Michaels 2 days prior to the event. There's no telling what's going to happen. It's open to the public, and you can see these two superstars Thursday, the 18th of September at 5 p.m. at Brindley Place, located in the Birmingham City Center. And speaking of Birmingham, let's get to the rest of the card for one night only. WWF titles on the line as the Hitman Bret Hart squares off against The Undertaker. How about the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, against two-time Slammy Award winner Owen Hart? And that hip cat, Dude Love, takes on Hunter Hearst Helmsley. And we all know no love lost between those two superstars. It's all happening next Saturday night, September the 20th. It's one night only from the Birmingham NEC.
No, the come on shotgun, two out of control freight trains heading toward each other on the same track when LOD take on the Nation of Domination.
The opponent from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 211 pounds, to sexy Graham Christopher.
There he is. I wonder if dear old daddy Jerry the King Lawler. Give me a break, Michael Cole. Every week you're that with the alleged. It is the real deal. There he is. Too sexy. Not only is Brian Christopher great talent, he's also the son of Jerry the King Lawler. Take a look. The future of wrestling could very well be. I think he's definitely the future of the light heavyweight division immediately here in the World Wrestling Federation. But I know his matchup with at Ground Zero with Scott Putski really didn't settle anything as Scott Putski suffered a terrible injury.
That's right, Brian Christopher and Scott Putski at Louisville, Kentucky at Ground Zero. It was a great matchup until the point where Christopher came off the ropes, hit Putski outside the ring, and Putski suffered a knee injury. The next day he went under the knife, he had surgery. He's going to be out an indefinite amount of time. We hope to have Scott Putski back in the World Wrestling Federation sooner rather than later. But this should be a great matchup. Brian Christopher in a light heavyweight division matchup against Super Loco from Hidalgo, Mexico. 23 years old, a newcomer here in the WWF.
It seems to be that Brian Christopher's having a little bit of a laugh. Maybe he's taking Super Loco lightly. I can tell you that's going to be a mistake. This Super Loco is an incredible talent.
He's been a light heavyweight champion in Mexico. He's also wrestled in Japan, and Super Loco really can get it on. Fly in action there. Brian Christopher with a big drop kick, and this should be a high-flying event. Whenever these light heavyweights get together, the action is tremendous. 215 pounds and under in order to be part of the light heavyweight division here in the World Wrestling Federation.
So cocky, so brash, just like dear old daddy.
Super Loco, great move, nice takedown. Christopher in trouble, surprise there. Nice arm drag by Super Loco. There's another one, Christopher in trouble. Overmatched right now by Loco with a spinning heel kick. No, goes Christopher outside the ring.
Yeah, I think the joke's on Christopher right now. Watch out.
Cartwheel over the top. Oh, what a takedown. Super Loco, and listen to this crowd.
Boy, the fans didn't know who Super Loco was when he came in, but they certainly know him now, and so does Brian Christopher. Oh,
another move over the top rope. Brian Christopher, I think he thinks he's back in Memphis.
He wishes he was on Beale Street right now, or maybe in dear old daddy's arms.
Too sexy Brian Christopher in all kinds of trouble, and Super Loco making a huge impression here in his first matchup in the World Wrestling Federation.
Christopher has been a great success in the WWF, no doubt about that, but a little bit cocky, a little bit overconfident, but Super Loco left himself open right there.
And Kevin, you have an interesting article in this magazine concerning Brian Christopher and his alleged dad, Jerry the King Lawler.
No allegations necessary. Face first to the mat. But I'll tell you what, Brian Christopher is a phenomenal talent. Jerry the King Lawler was as big a star as Elvis was in Memphis, Tennessee.
Drop kick behind the head and Super Loco in trouble. And there's Brian Christopher, too sexy. He's got the cocky attitude back all of a sudden.
Christopher was on the receiving end, but he's done an excellent job of changing the momentum of the match. If you could control the momentum in the light heavyweight division, you can win just about every match.
Look out! Oh, my! Brian Christopher in total control now. You realize Christopher's favorite wrestler growing up wasn't his dad? It was Jackie Fargo.
Another Memphis legend, but I'll tell you what, Brian Christopher looks a whole lot like his dad. He acts a lot like his dad. And I would definitely say that the acorn didn't fall too far from the tree.
Brian Christopher!
Talk about acorns!
Super Loco now, trying to gain momentum. Oh, look at that kick! Christopher down in trouble. Super Loco from Hidalgo, Mexico, whips Christopher off the ropes. Oh, big clothesline!
Loco needs to follow up. He's got to stay on top of Brian Christopher.
Here's Loco now, working off the ropes. Oh, nice move. Hooks the leg. This could be it. There's two. Christopher kicks out. Almost had it. Super Loco does a lot of playing to the crowd here. He really needs to follow up, as you said, Kevin, on these moves as he backs Christopher into the corner.
Well, the young man's got a tremendous personality, but he really needs to stay focused. He has a chance to make an instant name for himself in the World Wrestling Federation. If he can defeat Brian Christopher right here on Shotgun, this would be a career maker.
Oh! Right on the back of the head. Brian Christopher could be done right here. Super Loco looks like he's going to go up and work off the top rope. Referee Jack Doan counting him down. Oh, he missed with a spin. Christopher moving out of the way. And he can't even stand up. Still feeling the results of those kicks from Super Loco.
Oh, he's got him set up now here in the corner.
This could be the too sexy drop, Kevin. There it is. He could end it right here. Super Loco landing on the back of his head. And here goes Christopher up to the top ropes. We've seen this move in the past. This could end it if he connects here. Christopher points to the sky. Here he comes. Oh, this is it. This should be it. He covers Loco. There's two and three. It's all over. Too sexy Brian Christopher victorious over newcomer Super Loco here on Shotgun.
Despite the loss, I think Super Loco really proved a lot here this week on Shotgun. Take another look. You see the power exhibited by Brian Christopher and then follows up with the high impact leg drop off the top rope. Christopher was victorious, but he was pushed to the limit by a young man in the light heavyweight division that could have quite a future, Super Loco, right here on Shotgun.
Brian Christopher victorious. I'll tell you what, he is one of the front runners as we head toward a light heavyweight division champion. Still to come on Shotgun, Animal and Hawk from the Legion of Doom take on Farouk and Kama from the Nation of Domination. Two teams on a collision course. You'll see it coming up on Shotgun.
And up next, we will document Stone Cold's tirade as of late. What will he do next?
Welcome back to Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. I'll tell you what, Stone Cold Steve Austin has been on a rampage the past couple of weeks. The rattlesnake has been coiled and has been striking at everyone in the World Wrestling Federation. And this all began when Commissioner Slaughter suspended Stone Cold's license just a couple of weeks ago.
And Michael, it was almost as if we saw Stone Cold go over the edge. Remember when our camera crews went down to Texas? We visited Stone Cold Steve Austin in that ambush-style interview. We really got a true insight, I think, as to what's going on inside the mind of Stone Cold Steve Austin. It certainly was very enlightening.
The rattlesnake is out of control. Nonetheless, Owen Hart advances in the Intercontinental Tournament. And the tournament continues this week on Raw. It's Dude Love versus Brian Pillman. Who's going to advance? And the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, meets Farouk. But still to come this week on Shotgun, we have tag team action with Animal and Hawk from the Legion of Doom taking on Farouk and Kama from the Nation of Domination. Back to Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. Kevin, I'll tell you what, this is going to be a lot of fun.
Oh, Howard Finkelman, better watch out.
His opponent, weighing in at 87 pounds, Little Lucky.
There's Little Lucky taking on Federation mini action. The minis making their debut at Ground Zero. Max Mini taking on El Torito. What an entertaining matchup that was.
It certainly was. And I know Jerry the King Lawler didn't have such a great time at ringside. But nonetheless, they are very entertaining, to say the least. And
well, Kevin, to talk about entertaining, Shawn Michaels, his original appearance in Birmingham, UK fans, was canceled earlier this month. But we got a double dip for you to make up for that. Shawn and the British Bulldog, your own British Bulldog, will be at the Brindley Place in Birmingham City Center Thursday, September 18th. That's 2 days before, one night only, at 5 p.m. It is open to the public. And don't forget, it one night only, Shawn will meet the Bulldog for the European Championship. You see El Torito now working on Little Lucky. I'll tell you what, the Headbangers will also defend the WWF Tag Team Championship for the first time this Monday on Raw, against a very formidable team, to say the least, Bret Hart and the British Bulldog.
What an opportunity for the Headbangers.
Whoa! Whirlybird! Torito out of the ring.
The Headbangers are going to find out, I think, very quickly that becoming champions is easier than staying champions.
Look out! Little Lucky on the top rope gets his balance. Look at this! El Torito in trouble. Little Lucky. I mean, that's got to be a huge drop for these little guys. They're only going 86, 87 pounds.
Well, pound for pound, they're some of the strongest athletes in the world. And you see they are absolutely fearless. El Torito and Little Lucky here doing battle on shotgun.
Referee Jack Doe now going to begin the count on El Torito. He is the tallest one in the ring.
He's a mini ref. Get out of here.
For Jack Doe, that's saying something, as El Torito hits Little Lucky from behind.
Now, Mrs. Jack Doan will be writing us another letter every time we pick on poor Jack.
I'll tell you what, though, Kevin, these minis are entertaining, but they're great athletes.
Well, they certainly are. You cannot discount their athletic ability. They really do give it their all inside the squared circle. And I'll tell you what, you got a man like the Interrogator, 7 feet, 350 pounds. Oh. You got a guy like Little Lucky here, 87 pounds. There certainly is a difference, but all are great athletes.
And I like their costumes as well. El Torito with the horns on his mask there, and Little Lucky with a little shamrock.
It's almost your suit.
Hey, everybody's a comedian, Kevin. Hey, you're not going to want to miss this week on Raw. The Intercontinental Tournament will continue. I guess we're finally going to get a chance to see the Brian Pillman versus Dude Love matchup. And I understand that Commissioner Slaughter has put in a provision. Ooh, nice move by El Torito, which will mean that Goldust is barred from the building. So it will be Pillman against Dude Love. And then the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, will take on Farouk as the Intercontinental Tournament continues. This is mini action now. That's Little Lucky climbing back into the ring against El Torito. Also on Raw this week, the Patriot will take on Owen Hart, and a tag matchup, the Headbangers putting the WWF tag team titles on the line against Bret Hitman Hart and the British Bulldog. Cover there. Look at this by Little Lucky now. Look at this move. Nice takeover. There's the flip. There's two. Oh, El Torito kicks out after two. Little Lucky weighing in at about 90 pounds, about 88 pounds, I guess. El Torito about 104. There's a big right hand now to the side of the head of Little Lucky. And El Torito totally in control of this matchup. Look at the strength here from El Torito lifting the 90-pound. Little Lucky is tossing him on a Jack Doan.
Here we go.
He can cover Doan here. Lucky moved out of the way, and Doan got it from Torito. Unbelievable.
Mrs. Jack Doan is definitely writing us now.
Little Lucky moves out of the way, and there goes the little bull out of the ring, but he hangs on somehow. Little Lucky now misses with the, I guess, attempted crossbody. Little Lucky now off the second rope. Oh, look at this. El Torito. Oh, nice arm drag takedown. This is exciting action. Here's a cover. But Jack Doan trying to get up. There's two, almost three, before the little bull kicks out.
Boy, the referees were on the receiving end at Ground Zero. And things continuing here on shotgun is Jack Doan on the receiving end from both minis.
El Torito slamming Little Lucky to the canvas. Man, 90, I guess, 5 pounds El Torito weighed in on.
95, are you kidding me?
Here we go now, off the second rope.
This is gonna hurt. He get on. I need to get on that scale.
Here's the little bull. Flying through the air.
That'll do it.
This should be it. There's two and three. It's all over. El Torito, the little bull, victorious over Little Lucky on shotgun.
Very exciting action from the minis, as always, right here on shotgun.
Here's a special look at Triple H and Dude Love. Kevin, this should be a very interesting matchup. There he is from Philadelphia, Flash Funk, taking on the Sultan. Talk about different styles.
Yeah, they certainly are. Flash Funk, of course, the high-flying master, and the Sultan, more ground-based, of course, the suplex master, thanks in large part to his manager, his trainer, the Iron Sheik, who is at ringside with the Sultan. This is going to be a very physical contest.
And there are rumors that Flash will be appearing at one night only at the Birmingham NEC, sold out right around the corner, Saturday night, September 20th. The main event, of course, the British Bulldog, the European champion, taking on Shawn Michaels. Those two will be at Brindley Place in Birmingham City Center, Thursday, September 18th, 2 days before one night only at 5 p.m. It is an event open to the public, of course, to make up for Shawn Michaels' event, which was canceled a bit earlier this month in Birmingham. Flash Funk now set to go against the Sultan in the middle of the ring. This should be a physical matchup. And fans, the superstar line is up and running. 0891-299-888. The maximum cost of the call is £3, 50p a minute, regardless of the time of the call. If you're under 18 years of age, parental permission is required before calling. Speaking of that Hell in a Cell match, do you think we're finally going to get some resolution to this feud between The Undertaker and Shawn?
I don't really know. I know that Shawn Michaels really seems to be gaining momentum.
Oh!
He becomes more and more brash, more and more brazen every week. We saw a lot of that this past week on Raw. I've got a feeling he's going to have some tricks up his sleeve, just like he did at Ground Zero.
The Sultan, 6'2", 290, slamming Flash Funk to the canvas. He's returning from an injury. Had some ribs broken a few months ago.
A slow healing rib cage injury. Anybody who's ever hurt their ribs knows it takes forever for it to heal. And the Sultan now just beginning to get back to 100%. The Iron Sheik has been vigorously training this man, trying to get him prepared for battle once again.
The Sultan in total control now over Flash Funk, who goes 6'1", 245 pounds. Misses with the right hand, though. There's Flash with a slide underneath. Catches him with a big right hand in the abdomen. And here comes Flash Funk, starting to feel the groove and get into the action. Standing drop kick, the Sultan in trouble. Here's Flash again, setting up the Sultan. Oh, another drop kick. There goes the Sultan out of the ring. From Philadelphia, trying to gain some momentum, trying to work his way out of the sleeper being applied by the Sultan. Here comes Flash, big left hand down to the abdomen. Flash Funk taking control, off the ropes now. The Sultan misses with the right hand. Here's Flash, oh, nice takedown. The Sultan in trouble.
Big head of steam there, and now Flash Funk seizing the momentum once again.
Here's Flash working with the right hand, whip into the corner now. Oh, big elbow. The Sultan in La La Land. Here's Flash now, up on the top ropes. The Sultan better turn around. He better look out. Here's Flash, crossbody. This could be it. There's two. Oh, the Sultan gets the shoulder up at the last moment.
Two and a whole bunch.
There's the Sheik. The Sheik's in trouble.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Flash Funk. Oh, a right hand, and the sheet down off the apron. Assault misses with a kick. Here's Flash with a right hand. Bounces off the rope. Now spinning heel kick. That could be it.
Boy, he caught him right on the butt of the jaw.
Here we go now. He's going up. We could see the funky Flash Flash. Here he is now. Top rope. Oh, my. Hooks the leg. This should be it. There's two and three. Flash Funk victorious over the Salt.
Little added extra there on that one. Turned it into a leg drop off the top. But Flash Funk with a big win right here on Shotgun. Great competitive matchup.
And an important win for Flash Funk to beat a big man like the Sultan. Flash Funk victorious. Don't forget, this week on Raw, what an event. The Headbangers putting the tag team titles on the line against Bret Hitman Hart and the British Bulldog. Up next on Shotgun, Animal and Hawk, the Legion of Doom, on a collision course as they take on Kama and Farouk from the Nation. Gun Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly, what a tag team matchup we're getting set for. Farouk and Kama from the Nation of Domination set to take on the Road Warriors. Animal and Hawk, the Legion of Doom, and this crowd is pumped for this big matchup.
They are on their feet. And there they are, Hawk and Animal.
Tell you what, LOD was involved in the Fatal 4-Way match at Ground Zero, the Fatal 4-Way match where the Headbangers won the WWF Tag Team Championship. Ironically, it was LOD, the first team to be eliminated.
And you know the score is far from settled with the Godwins, who, introduced us to a new family member this week.
Uncle Cletus making his debut this past week on Raw. I'm sure we'll see him in the weeks to come. Here's Animal. Kama misses with a right hand. Oh, a big crossbody. Animal knocks down the 6'7", 340-pound Kama Mustafa. Backs him into the ropes now. Whips Kama into the ropes. Look at this power. Animal with a big body slam. Look at this. Kama Mustafa in trouble. Animal working on the left arm now, and here comes Hawk. Hawk off the second rope. Kama is in La La Land.
Of course, the Nation of Domination, a unified team, but not as much continuity, not anywhere near the experience that the legendary Legion of Doom have.
The former Florida State Seminole working now on Hawk. Backs him into the ropes. Whips him off the ropes now. Uh-oh, reversal, swinging neck breaker. What a reversal by Hawk, and if he can get to Animal, his place will explode, and here he comes. Here comes Animal. Farouk trying to get to Kama. Uh-uh. Animal won't let it happen. Standing drop kick. Here comes Kama now through the rope. Drop kick from Animal. The Nation in trouble. Big boot to the midsection. Clothesline. Kama outside the ring. Here we go. 2-on-1 now. Double team action from LOD. Farouk into the corner. Here's the slingshot. There goes Hawk. Look out. Animal with a big forearm. Farouk in all kinds of trouble. They're now calling for the Doomsday Device. Hawk's going to go up to the top rope. Animal trying now to lift Farouk up on his shoulders. Oh, no, from behind. Rocky Maivia interfering from behind. And Hawk in all kinds of trouble now. Where is Commissioner Slaughter when you need him to keep the rest of the Nation out of the way? The bell rings. This matchup is over. Oh, look out. Ken Shamrock, the world's most dangerous man, heading to the ring to help LOD. Look at this. Shamrock cleaning house. He should be the new commissioner, taking care of business. Ken Shamrock. There we go. Right hand to Rocky Maivia, belly to belly. the Nation of Domination hightailing it out of the ring. LOD victorious with the help of Ken Shamrock. UK fans, don't forget, Shawn Michaels and the British Bulldog will be at Brindley Place in Birmingham City Center Thursday, September 18th. That's 2 days before one night only. It takes place at 5 p.m. The event open to the public. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Have a great week, everybody. They both love the United States. Also, hatred. The two hate the Hart Foundation. The question is, though, how can Vader and the Patriot work together? Will they make a formidable team? They're both All-American football players. Vader from Colorado, the Patriot from the University of South Carolina. They do have that common bond of patriotism. But will the teamwork be there? Will they be able to work together when they get up against the Hart Foundation at WWF Bad Blood? Vader now set to lock up with the Sultan. We talked about the flag match. Vader and the Patriot taking on Brett, the British Bulldog, at WWF Bad Blood. What about the flag match? Tell us about the rules, Kevin.
Well, basically, it's a tag team matchup, but the winners have to go get the opponent's flag. That's how you win. And look at Vader just hammering away on the Sultan, wasting no time here on Shotgun.
The Mastodon, 6'5", 458 pounds from Denver, Colorado, going to work on the Sultan from the Middle East. The Sultan goes 6'2", 290. I'll tell you what, though. Vader makes him look like a mini.
Yeah, he certainly is, and that's no small feat. No pun intended. Can you imagine what it's going to be like, Michael, inside the keel on Sunday, October the 5th? If Brett the Hitman Hart, the British Bulldog, captures that American flag, what they're going to do, how they'll desecrate Old Glory right there in St. Louis?
Vader, with a nice move off the ropes, knocks the Sultan down. The Mastodon in control of this matchup this week on Shotgun. What a show we have for you. You're going to want to stay tuned. We're going to have all the latest on the Rampage of the Rattlesnake, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Vader off the second rope, knocks Sultan down. This looks like it could be a quick match. Here's the cover now. There's two. The Sultan somehow gets his shoulder up, and Vader yells at the referee. One night only tonight, of course, the European Championship on the line. The British Bulldog defending against the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. You now see the man they call Vader going to work on the Sultan. Misses with the right hand, and the Sultan catches Vader. And Vader in all kinds of trouble now as the Sultan from the Middle East goes to work now on the Mastodon. The man they call Vader, the Iron Sheik, barking out signals at ringside to his man, the Sultan.
Look at the Sultan tearing away on the man they call Vader. It's got to be odd for Vader to hear the positive response from the fans. This man who has done so many ill deeds in his career, now hearing the cheers, especially from the fans of the United States and his tag team partnership with the Patriot.
Oh, look out. Look at that strength by the Sultan knocking Vader outside the ring. And Vader having trouble, I think, trying to find out where he is. Trying to shake the cobwebs out of his head, and here comes the Sultan out of the ring. Oh, but Vader caught him with the left hand. I guess he was playing possum.
I think Vader always does better with a few cobwebs. You get that first shot in on Vader, and then he's ripe. You know what I mean? He's ready to go.
Look at this reversal now. The Sultan off the ropes. Vader catches it with a big clothesline, and the Sultan spun around a 360 in midair.
And now Vader going to the corner.
Look out.
Boy, he's looking to capitalize right away.
The finishing move on the way. This could be the Vader bomb from the man they call Vader.
Look at the people on their feet.
The Sultan won't get up from this. They're 2-3. It's all over. The man they call Vader victorious on Shotgun.
Look at the crowd.
victorious. There he is, 458-pounder from Colorado. This is what happened at the end of the matchup. The Sultan taking a big right hand, spinning around in the air, and then Vader setting him up for the Vader bomb, and Vader gets the victory. Right now, here's a WWF update.
Hey, folks, I'm Todd Pettengill with the latest in the World Wrestling Federation. Well, the countdown is on to WWF Bad Blood in Your House, Sunday night, October the 5th, where The Undertaker will square off against Shawn Michaels. It's Hell in a Cell. Now, that means the entire ring will be covered with a steel cage. Nobody's going to get in, nobody's going to get out, so hopefully this time we will have a winner. And who knows, by the time Hell in a Cell rolls around, we could very well have new WWF champions. Two of them, in fact, because Shawn Michaels could be the new WWF European champion, and The Undertaker could regain the WWF championship from the Hitman Bret Hart. Now, to find out how that could happen, let's turn our attention to one night only at the NEC in Birmingham, exclusively live on Sky Box Office. Folks, we are just hours away from this event. If you need more information on how you can see the World Wrestling Federation on pay-per-view, call the Sky Box Office information line at 0990-800-888. Now, I told you Shawn Michaels could be the new WWF European champion by the time Hell in a Cell rolls around. And that's because in just a few hours, the Heartbreak Kid squares off against your very own British Bulldog for that European title. Shawn Michaels has taken every opportunity to try and weaken the Bulldog, but so far to no avail. This one should be a classic confrontation for WWF Gold in Birmingham at the NEC in just hours. Now, the WWF title will also be on the line when Bret the Hitman Hart faces the man from the dark side, The Undertaker. There is absolutely no love lost between these two WWF superstars, and anything is likely to happen when the dark side squares off against five-time WWF champion Bret Hart. In tag action, you will see the champions, the Headbangers, take on Savio and Miguel of Los Periques. The world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, makes his UK debut against the very cunning Owen Hart, who just happens to be a two-time Slammy Award winner. Of course, he stole the Slammys, but nobody seems to remember that. The Summer of Love will officially come to a close as Dude Love steps into the squared circle against Hunter Hearst Helmsley. You will also see Legion of Doom. Oh, what a rush as they take on Henry and Phineas Godwin. It is going to be incredible in just hours at the NEC in Birmingham. Talking about this Saturday night, exclusively live on Sky Box Office at 8 p.m. That's right, the first time ever the World Wrestling Federation has been on pay-per-view in the UK, and it's one night only. I almost forgot. Another first from the World Wrestling Federation for the UK is the WWF Half Hour Free For All, which is 30 minutes prior to one night only. All Sky Satellite subscribers can turn to Astra Channel 60 this Saturday night at 7:30 p.m. for a live sneak peek preview of what's going to be happening at one night only. For those of you with cable TV, contact your local cable operator for more information. And get ready, UK and Ireland, and everybody across the world for an unbelievable night from the World Wrestling Federation, without a doubt the undisputed leader in sports entertainment.
And right back to the action here with a light heavyweight divisional matchup. Take a look at our first appearance on Shotgun for El Pantera, a great star from Mexico, a man who has competed all over the globe. And Michael Cole, we have seen his opponent. Coming up here in just a few seconds, we've seen him before, Super Loco, a man who, when I first saw his name, I thought was you. Getting out from behind the mic, but no, it's indeed a great star from Mexico, and this is going to be a very exciting light heavyweight divisional matchup. El Pantera from Acapulco, Mexico. Super Loco comes your way from Hidalgo, Mexico. He's a 23-year-old, and here he comes down the ramp. Super Loco, 5'11", 200 pounds.
Boy, he's firing himself up.
This is a light heavyweight division matchup. In order to compete, you have to be 215 pounds or under. And I can't wait for this one. Should be some high-flying excitement as these two Mexican superstars get ready to get it on.
Well, these two men are no strangers. They've faced each other before here in this light heavyweight divisional matchup. But this time, boy, the lights, the specter of the World Wrestling Federation. It's going to be much more intense than any other battle these two have ever had before.
Super Loco starts off with a big clothesline on El Pantera. Super Loco has won a few championships, including the light heavyweight championship at the UWA down in Mexico. Look at that move now. Great balance by Pantera. Ooh, nice power move.
They have many different weight classes. Wait a second.
Oh, here's a quick cover that time, but only two. Referee Jack Doan working this match. What was that? Kevin, that looks like you and your wife dancing.
Hey, now.
Look at this. Pantera now off the rope. Super Loco catches him with the right hand. El Pantera, a champion in his own right. Welterweight champion, super welterweight champion, all south of the border down in Mexico. Ooh, Super Loco missed that time off the top rope.
They do have a lot of different weight classes in different parts of the globe. Of course, in the United States, it's mainly the focus on the super heavyweights. But that's why this light heavyweight division is such a treat for the fans. And take a look here, as Pantera is going for the submission maneuver. This is a surfboard. If he's able to turn Super Loco all the way up and arch that back.
Look at this.
You see Loco's trying to unarch his back. He's trying to use his stomach. And now, wait a second.
Oh, look at this. Ooh, two before Pantera got out of that one. Ooh, big boot now into the abdomen. Talking about the light heavyweight division, Kevin, WWF officials scouting all over the world looking for the best light heavyweights. We understand that there will be a tournament. Ooh, a champion will be crowned at some point down the road. Who is your favorite in this division?
Well, it's too early to call a favorite right now, Michael. There's a lot of men that's going to be coming from all over the globe. I certainly want to mention, I want to send out best wishes and a speedy recovery to Scott Putski, who did have surgery following his matchup with Brian Christopher at Ground Zero.
Look at this.
Look at Pantera.
What balance. El Pantera, nice takedown of Super Loco. Loco hits him with the right hand, and look at this. Loco off the ropes. Uh-oh, look out. Misses. Loco down outside the ring. Oh, no. Here comes El Pantera. What was that? Looks like an elastic man. Rubber band man through the ropes and knocks Loco down. Here's El Pantera again. Look out, Kevin Kelly. Oh, my. What a move. El Pantera, we got to take a break. We'll be right back. Cole and Kevin Kelly just about out of breath. It's been Super Loco in control over El Pantera. Look at Loco now going to the top. Oh, man. El Pantera in La La Land.
Yeah, but Super Loco's absorbed a lot of punishment in this battle, Michael. He's unable to capitalize. These two men, as I said, no strangers to one another. Such an even matchup.
Here's Pantera now outside the ring. What is Super Loco going to do now? Off the rope. Oh, a plunge off the top rope. And El Pantera in trouble. What a move that time.
That definitely is high risk.
Tell you what, I don't know if Super Loco hurt El Pantera or Loco hurt himself, favoring that left leg.
That is leg or, well, something else. Anyway,
Super Loco now making his way back up to the ring. El Pantera still trying to shake the cobwebs out of his head. El Pantera in a little bit of trouble now, but Super Loco hurt himself as he came through the ropes. And Super Loco trying to, I guess, catch his breath, still favoring that left leg. Referee Jack Doan counting El Pantera, the Panther, back into the ring. What's going to happen here? His matchup has slowed down just a bit. Oh!
El Pantera into the ring. Here we go now off the ropes. This is the Panther. It means Panther in Spanish, Kevin, as Super Loco means super crazy.
Really? Loco means crazy. I never would have guessed.
A little translation there.
Thank
Here's
you
El Pantera
little.
Off the ropes. Look at this. Spinning him around. Oh, nice takedown by the Panther. Quick as a cat. Amply named. We were talking about the possibility of a light heavyweight tournament, Kevin. Oh, look at this. Pete Rose sliding into home.
Safe.
Super Loco, a little baseball there with the help of El Pantera. What's the cat doing? Going up now to the top rope. Look at Super Loco. Oh, my. Woo. What a move. We got to take another look at that, Kevin Kelly.
Absolutely unbelievable, the high-risk maneuver. First, though, grabs him a handful of hair. Yes, indeed. Safe into second base. And then El Pantera, the moonsault all the way to the floor. Looked like Super Loco caught the brunt end of that one.
Oh, big back body drop. El Pantera in trouble. Kevin, we're talking about the possibility of a light heavyweight tournament. What about the Intercontinental Tournament that's underway right now?
Well, moves on. Of course, there'll be another first-round matchup this week on Raw, and we'll take an in-depth look in that tournament. We'll look at the brackets and see the matchups.
Oh, Hurricane Rana missed! Super Loco missed, and he is in trouble. El Pantera, ooh, Hurricane Rana off the the top ropes, takes down Super Loco. El Pantera now off the ropes. Look at this. Look at this maneuver. Sudden death flip. Here's the cover. 2 and 3. It's over. El Pantera victorious over Super Loco. Hachaka.
It all goes back to basics, Michael Cole. A wrestling maneuver won this matchup for El Pantera.
The WWF presents the Slam of the Week.
Look out! Ah! Good Lord! Isn't that amazing? That's absolutely amazing. That is totally justified. Max Manning now. Look at him climbing up. All the way up to the top rope. What is Max Manning going to do? Yeah! Drop kick from way up
off the top. Can you imagine that? The size of this little guy coming off the top.
And what a pinning combination! He's got it!
The WWF Slam of the Week.
Michael, I didn't know you had that Latin spirit there. Latin what? Why don't you sit down? Take a load off. Relax. People are starting to stare.
Folks, can't beat that.
Left with rhythm, he ain't.
Who are you talking about? Kevin Kelly.
Unfortunately, I'm talking about you, Val.
Here they are, Jesus Castillo, Jose Estrada from Los Boricuas. A very interesting team coming up here. The Honky Tonk Man leading Rockabilly, his protege, and also Jesse James out to the ring. And Kevin, there is a whole reason for this matchup.
Well, there's a story right here coming down the ramp, but this story began earlier this week in an 8-man tag. As all four men that are getting set to face one another were on the same team. That's right, Rockabilly and Jesse James teamed with Los Boricuas against the DOA. And you see, Jesse James made a mistake there. He clobbered one of the guys from Los Boricuas, and all of a sudden, it's a push, it's a shove, it's a right hand, and then that leads to the heart punch. Ill feelings aside, if the match totally broke down from that point. In fact, there was a big brawl that ensued following that. The Los Boricuas challenged Rockabilly and Jesse James, and I'm wondering if Honky Tonk Man's playing Don King here.
Rockabilly and Double J quickly starting this matchup against Los Boricuas. Rockabilly tossing Jose Estrada outside the ring. And now a double team on Jesus Castillo. Off the ropes, Jesus, double elbow. Jesus in all kinds of trouble. What do you make of this tag team, Kevin Kelly? Rockabilly and Jesse James. I mean, just a couple of months ago, Honky Tonk Man wanted Jesse James to be his protege. Jesse James broke his family heirloom, the guitar, said no way.
Well, Jesse James was the first man to turn down the Honky Tonk Man. Of course, the second there was Rockabilly. Who would have thought, baby, the Honky Tonk Man has finally gotten Jesse James to see things his way? Could this be his creation of perhaps the greatest tag team of all time?
Jesus Castillo now from Los Boricuas working on Rockabilly, the three-time WWF Tag Team Champion. Nice takedown there by Rockabilly.
Just out of camera range, we saw Double J influence Jesus' move through the ropes there. Already starting to see a little continuity between these two. I like the look of this team, as does the Honky Tonk Man, smiling and clapping in the corner.
Here's Jesse James now working on Jesus Castillo. Ooh, a big knee across the sternum. Hey, Kevin, do you know what Boricuas means?
No, I don't, but look at Jesse James taunting our Shotgun Saturday Night colleagues, Jim Cornette and Jim Ross.
Here's a cover, two, Castillo kicks out.
What does Boricuas mean?
It means Puerto Rico. That's the country where the four members of Los Boricuas hail from. And Jesse James has been very impressive in this matchup as he tags in Rockabilly. Castillo, the son of the late Hurricane Castillo, senior of Caribbean fame. Rockabilly, a great athlete in his own right, went to college on a rodeo scholarship.
Not only that, he was a... Oh, look at Jesse James here. You're starting to see the continuity. I'm telling you, these guys have something. You can just feel the chemistry that they have working between them.
And that's interesting, since Jesse James and Rockabilly haven't been the best of buddies as of late. Here's Jesse James now in the ring. Jesus Castillo really needs to make a tag. He's in trouble. Jose Estrada hasn't seen the light of day. Here's Jesse James off the ropes. Little dance. Ooh, big elbow across the sternum. Here's the cover now. There's two. Castillo somehow, resiliency takes over there, and he kicks out. Jesse James now tags in the former Billy Gunn. Rockabilly going to work once again on Castillo. Into the turnbuckle. Rockabilly now in control. Irish whip. Castillo whipped into the corner. Here comes Rockabilly now. Flying across the ring. Misses Jesus Castillo. Rockabilly in all kinds of trouble down in the center of the ring.
Boy, that smile is turned upside down on the Honky Tonk Man as Rockabilly's eyes roll skyward. Check out Jesus. He needs to make a tag. Jose Estrada fresh on the apron. Looks like Rockabilly needs one too.
Here's Rockabilly now over toward Jesse James, and here comes Double J, the U.S. Marine. He fought in the Gulf War, but Jose Estrada catches him with the right hand. Oh, there's a standing drop kick. Another drop kick. Jesse James and Rockabilly in trouble. Look out. All all four men now in the ring. Los Boricuas in control. Estrada and Castillo. What's going to happen here? They're setting up Jesse James and Rockabilly. Leapfrog, right hand, right hand. Uh-oh, Rockabilly and Jesse in trouble.
Well, these four men were all on the same team last week. You can see how fortunes have changed.
Jesus Castillo working on Rockabilly outside the ring. He better watch out for the honky-tonk man. He saw him. There's the cover. And three, it's over. Give the assist to the guitar. Double J and Rockabilly victorious.
Well, both Rockabilly and Double J with a fondness for that style of music. And look at this. Miguel and Savio are in. Well, we've got to try to get some order restored here. In fact, fans, right now, let's take you to what happened last week on Raw.
Wow, Stone Cold is out of control. First he gets the restraining order, then he's done to the King. What's he going to do next? You see Owen Hart heading down the ramp with a bunch of security guards, police officers.
Yeah, those are police officers, but I've got a feeling that that's not going to stop Stone Cold Steve Austin. I'm sure he could care less. Owen Hart could have an entire battalion behind him. Stone Cold Steve Austin's going to find some way. You know, I've been thinking about this, Michael. He's going out of his way, Stone Cold Steve Austin, to give the Stone Cold Stunner to anybody who gets in his way. Jim Ross, Jerry the King Lawler, Commissioner Slaughter, who knows who's next, but I've got a feeling that what this is, it's an example for Owen Hart. The one man who he wants to give the Stone Cold Stunner to, not once, but over and over again, is that man right there. The man that nearly cost Stone Cold his career, his livelihood. You don't think Stone Cold Steve Austin, when he was riding around in his four-wheeler in Texas, was thinking about giving the Stone Cold Stunner to good old JR, do you? He was thinking about one man, that guy right there from Calgary.
Owen Hart now set to go to work with Flash Funk. Can you imagine what would happen if Owen Hart makes it to the finals of the Intercontinental Tournament at WWF Bad Blood in Your House in St. Louis on October 5th, wins the Intercontinental Tournament, and then must take the belt from Stone Cold Steve Austin as Stone Cold forfeits it at Bad Blood.
I'm not so sure I agree with that policy set forth by Commissioner Slaughter. You know, it's enough. Well, wait a second, quick lateral press there. It's enough that Stone Cold has to be there, but come on, to present the title. I mean, that's just a recipe for disaster, really asking for trouble. Stone Cold Steve Austin, by Bad Blood, is not going to be fit to compete. He's not going to be 100%. Owen Hart is fit to compete and is ready to go. It could be a long way back for Stone Cold Steve Austin if Owen Hart happens to maybe take advantage of that situation.
Flash Funk now with a reversal, working on Owen Hart. Flash off the ropes now, over top Owen Hart. Here's the leapfrog from Owen. Cartwheel by Flash Funk. Oh, misses with a spinning heel kick. Here's Owen, big clothesline, knocks Flash Funk down. Here's a cover now by Owen Hart. There's two, Flash Funk kicks out. Putting the flag over Owen Hart.
Little impromptu flag match, baby, who knows?
Oh, here's Flash now. Oh, my. Covers up now on Owen. There's two. Owen Hart somehow kicks out.
Well, we certainly want to apologize to our fans in Canada. Don't take any offense. Flash Funk not trying to desecrate the flag, just trying to defeat Owen Hart.
Here's Flash now off the top ropes. Uh-oh. Set himself up.
Oh, no.
Owen sets him up for the pile driver.
Watch this.
Oh! The move that injured Stone Cold Steve Austin. The pile driver. There's two and three. It's all over. Owen Hart victorious on shotgun.
We have seen pile drivers given before, but perhaps Owen Hart has capitalized on just a simple modification of a very devastating maneuver and has turned it even to something even more devastating.
And that pile driver, Kevin, a very, very devastating move, as you said. Let's take a look at what happened here.
Drops him right down. Of course, Stone Cold Steve Austin felt that at SummerSlam. We know we will see Steve Austin present the Intercontinental title to whoever wins the tournament at Bad Blood. And speaking of Bad Blood, as Owen Hart is doing bad things to Flash Funk with that flag.
Unweight 640 pounds.
Welcome back to Shotgun, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Michael Cole. Kevin Kelly is headed back to the locker room area to see if he can get a hold of Commissioner Slaughter for a ruling on that guitar incident between Rockabilly and Jesse James as they defeated Los Boricuas. Here they come now, the former WWF Tag Team Champions. The Godwins, Henry and Phineas, heading to the ring for this tag team matchup against Skull and 8-Ball from the Disciples of Apocalypse. What a card. The Godwins will be renewing their long simmering feud with the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, Animal and Hawk. And this should be a great tag team matchup this week on Shotgun. Henry and Phineas there carrying the Confederate flag to the ring, getting set to take on Skull now and 8-Ball from DOA. They're identical twins. They're hard to tell each other apart. I think this is Skull in the ring now working against Phineas. Speaking of that one-night-only card, the WWF Championship is on the line. Bret Hitman Hart, the five-time champion, will take on The Undertaker. This is a rematch of SummerSlam, where The Undertaker lost the title to Bret Hart. Skull now ducking underneath Phineas. Oh, a little do-si-do, tossing Phineas down. And here now comes 8-Ball. I guess, or Skull, whoever it is, but DOA anyway, knocks Phineas outside the ring. And here comes Cousin Henry out to see if he's okay, and now has a few words with the crowd. The British Bulldog will put the title on the line against the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. And folks, remember the last time the British Bulldog was in a huge event in England back in 1992 at SummerSlam, Wembley Stadium, 80,000 plus people. He won the Intercontinental Championship against brother-in-law Bret Hitman Hart. Into the ring now comes Henry Godwin, going to work on 8-Ball from the Disciples of Apocalypse. Speaking of the Godwins, they have a big tag team matchup on the way for WWF Bad Blood in just a couple of weeks. That at St. Louis, Missouri. They'll take on the Headbangers for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Henry Godwin, Irish Rip into the corner, but he catches 8-Ball now with a big elbow. Henry misses. Ooh, big boot. 8-Ball now in control over Henry Godwin. Here's a quick cover now on Henry. Jack Doan, the referee, with a two count before Henry Godwin kicks out. The look at that double team by Phineas. He pulls the ropes down and 8-Ball goes out of the ring. Here's the double feature now. Double team action as Phineas pulls the ropes down. And now another double team. Phineas distracting the referee and Henry going to work now on 8-Ball. Scoops him up, slams him to the canvas. Here's the cover now. Referee Jack Doan out of position. There's two. But somehow DOA kicks out and here comes Phineas again for the Godwins. Ooh, Phineas now and then Henry. DOA in trouble. Also tonight in the UK at Birmingham NEC at One Night Only. Ooh, the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, makes his debut in the United Kingdom. He will be in a zone as he takes on Owen Hart. I'll tell you what a matchup that's going to be. The last time Shamrock locked up in a big event against a Hart Foundation member, it was at SummerSlam against the British Bulldog. And folks, you all know what happened there. He literally flipped out. Here's Phineas now, misses in the corner, and Phineas in all kinds of trouble. Birmingham NEC tonight, One Night Only. Dude Love, the Summer of Love, comes to Birmingham just hours away. Oh, what a clothesline. Here comes Phineas now. All kinds of trouble. Phineas and Henry, the DOA. This is 8-Ball going to work on the Godwins, taking control of this matchup. Now you see all four men in the ring. There goes Henry. Look out. There's Uncle Cletus. There's Uncle Cletus, one of the newest members of the Godwin family. Oh, no. Phineas in trouble. And here comes Henry now. Uncle Cletus. Phineas covers. Here's the cover now. There's three. It's over. The Godwins victorious here on Shotgun. Folks, also tonight, just hours away at One Night Only, Tiger Ali Singh makes his UK debut. You'll see the Patriot take on Flash Funk. As I mentioned, Dude Love in action against Hunter Hearst Helmsley, and China will be at the Birmingham NEC. Uh-oh, look out. Here comes the rest of DOA. We'll see you in Birmingham. See you, everybody. Hello, everybody. everybody. Welcome to Shotgun, Michael Cole and Kevin Kelly. And here they come. Blackjack Windham, Blackjack Bradshaw, the new Blackjacks, an up-and-coming team here in the World Wrestling Federation.
You talk about two rugged Texas Cowboys. There they are, each over 6'6", right around that 280-pound mark. We haven't seen them in a couple of weeks here on Shotgun, but I'll tell you what, they're going to have their hands full. We're going to start things off with a very physical battle here on Shotgun. A couple of gentlemen representing their homeland of Puerto Rico, members of Los Boricuas on the scene.
New outfits for Savio Vega and Miguel Perez of Los Boricuas. Getting a little hipper, I guess you would say, Kevin.
Yeah, they're down with the people on the street. They certainly identify with the Puerto Rican community, both in the New York City area, of course, all across America, and in their native Puerto Rico. They still reside there. They split time between the United States mainland and Puerto Rico. And they certainly are a physical team. Like I said, it's going to be a rough, tough match to start it off.
Kevin, speaking of New York City, what an event this past week at Madison Square Garden in New York. The first time ever Raw was at the Garden. It was amazing.
It was a very special night indeed. And of course, highlighting all the great action that we saw this past week on Raw. Of course, we got to talk about Stone Cold Steve Austin, what he did to Vince McMahon, whether he's still employed. We'll talk about that later on. But Michael, what about the new European champion, Shawn Michaels, doing the impossible, the improbable, the unthinkable over in the UK, coming back crowned European champion now, the first man in WWF history to own the Grand Slam.
The Grand Slam, of course, winning the Tag Team Championship, the Intercontinental Championship, the World Wrestling Federation Championship, and now he's the European champion, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. As we're setting out for action, Miguel Perez starts it off against Blackjack Bradshaw.
Wow.
He's the young one of the group, and a nice takedown that time of Miguel Perez. What about the return of Ahmed Johnson this past week on Raw?
I was very surprised that Ahmed received the warm welcome that he did. Took a physical toll on him in his matchup with Rocky Maivia. He did advance to the semifinals. He will meet Farouk next week on Raw. And that's an old score to settle with the leader of the Nation of Domination. But Ahmed will be less than 100%. Suffered a hand injury during the match with Rocky Maivia. Severed some tendons or some nerves. We'll see if it has any impact in his match with Farouk.
Ooh, Miguel Perez with a big drop kick and Blackjack Bradshaw out of the ring. But quickly back up on the apron and into action against Miguel Perez. Speaking of injuries, Kevin, Farouk is advanced in the Intercontinental Tournament because Ken Shamrock is out with internal injuries. So Farouk advances to meet Ahmed. We'll talk all about the tournament a little bit later on in this broadcast. It's Savio Vega now in the ring working on Blackjack Bradshaw.
Listen to these chops. Wow. I mean, just hard concussion-type blows to the upper chest.
Oh! Big boot. Savio in trouble. Tell you what resiliency from Blackjack Bradshaw. Short clothesline, and here comes the veteran, Blackjack Windham.
Teacher-student relationship between these two. Of course, Windham, the veteran of over 15 years.
Oh!
There's a nice running lariat.
Here's a quick cover now of Savio Vega. Windham with a cover. There's two, but Savio kicks out. Blackjack Windham, a former two-time World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion. Of course, the son of the legendary Blackjack Mulligan. He and Blackjack Lonzo were tag team champs back in the 1970s. Oh, Savio Vega, nice reversal, and here come the chops again.
Ooh.
Ooh, rake of the eyes by Blackjack Windham, and now a big right hand.
Savio Vega, I think, has the hardest hands in the World Wrestling Federation. Loves to lay those chops in the corner. Windham wanted no part of that. The quick rake of the eyes. Now the tag is made. Here comes big Blackjack Bradshaw back in the ring. I know Windham's history is as of a tag team champion. Of course, the lineage of the Blackjacks, certainly shrouded in tag team gold. But this team has the makings of being a federation champion.
Look out, cross body. Here's a cover, Kevin. Two and almost three. Oh, and Bradshaw kicked out. Here's Savio now back. Oh, a big boot. Savio Vega. Look at that. I don't know. I think he knows where he is.
Savio and Miguel came within an eyelash, Michael, of becoming World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions at one night only. The Headbangers did get past it, but we'll see if the Headbangers are as lucky at Bad Blood when they take on the Godwins, who we will see a little later on battling Vader and the Patriot. Great tag team action here this week on Shotgun.
Here we go now. Savio Vega in trouble, lifted high in the air. Ooh, what a slam. Here's the cover now. There's two, almost three. Savio Vega kicks out. Bad Blood, Kevin, just 1 week away in St. Louis at the Kiel Center. Ooh, blocked that time. Here's Savio with the right hand. Trying to come back now, Savio Vega, but a rake of the eyes by Blackjack Windham.
I'm very curious to see what that Hell in a Cell looks like.
that specially constructed steel cage for the match with Shawn Michaels against The Undertaker.
Here's Blackjack Bradshaw now in the ring. Savio Vega really needs to make a tag. Can he get to Miguel Perez? No. Blackjack Windham, I should say Bradshaw, almost gets to Perez, and now he works on Vega.
They are hard to tell apart, that's for sure.
Oh, here we go. Sunset flip. Vega's got the cover. There's two, almost three, but Bradshaw kicks out.
Referee Tim White was a step out of position because having to admonish Miguel Perez for his antics in the corner. Perhaps Savio and Miguel could have won this matchup were it not for Miguel Perez.
Oh, a spinning heel kick off the turnbuckle. And Savio Vega may have saved himself there. Here comes the veteran Blackjack Windham. He'll drop the elbow on the sternum. Gonna cover Savio now. No, may have been a mistake there.
I'm surprised that the veteran Windham didn't go for the lateral press when he had the man down.
Trying now to lift Savio over in a suplex. Second time, can't get it. Savio now. Ooh, nice reversal. What strength by Savio Vega. Lifting the 6'7", 273-pound Windham. And can Windham get to Bradshaw? He does. Can Savio get to Miguel Perez? Oh, yes, he does. Here comes Miguel Perez. Perez going to work now on Blackjack Bradshaw with a big right hand. Off the ropes, Miguel Perez ducks under the right hand by Bradshaw. Ooh, a big drop kick. Bradshaw in trouble. Miguel Perez catches Windham with a drop kick. Perez, a house of fire now.
Perez and Savio Vega, no strangers. Longtime tag team partners in Puerto Rico.
Nice takedown. Here's the cover. There's two, but a save by Windham.
A modified Hurricanrana there from Miguel Perez. But you see now the double teaming tactics. And it appears the new Blackjacks are looking to finish things off here.
Uh-oh, look out. What's this? Uh-oh, here come the Estrada and Castillo. The other two members of Los Boricuas. Here's Perez from behind. He covers up. Oh, kick out that time by Windham.
Two and a whole bunch. It looked like Miguel had things rolled up tight and ready to go. Windham is out of...
Oh, look out. Oh, spinning heel kick. Savio caught him. Perez with a cover. This should be it. It's over.
What a victory for Los Boricuas over the Blackjacks. Here on Shotgun, give the assist to those two men, Mr. Estrada and Mr. Castillo, helping out Savio Vega and Miguel Perez. Los Boricuas with a huge victory on Shotgun this week. The Blackjacks will go home without the win.
So Cole and Kevin Kelly, and here he comes from Nashville, Tennessee, Kevin. Double J, Jesse James.
He's not singing any songs anymore. He's got a definite sneer on his face. Seems to be in a real foul mood, does Double J, Jesse James. But it's going to be a great contest with Flash Funk coming up. And I'll tell you what, Michael, electrifying week of action in the World Wrestling Federation. Raw is war. Of course, we did see Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker sort of get involved. I'd say The Undertaker won that round.
Yeah, this past week on Raw, Kevin, The Undertaker came out to answer Shawn Michaels' challenge, but it was a trap. It was an ambush. Hunter Hearst Helmsley, Rick Rude, and China attacking The Undertaker on the ramp, but The Undertaker got up and chased the quartet back to the locker room. Here comes Flash Funk set for this matchup with Jesse James. And UK fans, the superstar line is up and running. 0891-299-888. The maximum cost of the call is £3, 50p per minute, regardless of the time of the call. If you're under 18 years of age, you need parental permission required before calling. Flash Funk now set to do action. We're here with Double J, Jesse James, this week here on Shotgun. Don't forget Hell in a Cell, right around the corner at WWF Bad Blood. It's The Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels, a unique stipulation. The winner of that match will meet the WWF champion at Survivor Series in November.
Now, could you imagine if we saw a rematch from WrestleMania 12 from the Iron Man match, if it's Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker? Or what about a rematch from SummerSlam? You know The Undertaker would love to have the opportunity to get another crack at Bret the Hitman Hart.
And here's Jesse James now working on Flash Funk. And I'll tell you what, one quick other mention. At Survivor Series, that championship match will take place. Can you imagine if Bret Hart's still the champion and he defends the belt in front of his homeland in Montreal?
Absolutely. It is going to be a partisan crowd, to say the least. And look at Double J, very aggressive, starting off with some very stern boots to the midsection of Flash Funk. Like I said, not the usually jovial Double J.
What is that all about?
A little sarcastic edge to him. And I don't know if we can get a shot of him. The King, Jerry Lawler, down with our Shotgun Saturday Night colleagues, Jim Ross and Jim Cornette. I'm sure JR is going to have a tough time getting a word in edgewise with those two.
He really is, and it's interesting. Jerry the King Lawler's alleged son, Brian Christopher, actually lost to Flash Funk a few weeks back on Raw because Jerry the King Lawler tried to coach him. Actually, Christopher ended up getting beat.
I guess in your book, that would be an alleged dropkick that Flash Funk just hit.
No, that was a real dropkick
there.
Well,
Brian Christopher's a real son of Jerry Lawler. Will you please get a grip and stop saying that every week?
Oh, look at that by Flash Funk. What a takedown. Double J in trouble. Standing dropkick from Flash Funk. Loves to work in the air. There's a nice arm drag. Flash Funk in control.
Well, there's no bigger fan of the King than Jim Cornette. In fact, nobody can run their mouth quite like the King, well, other than Jim Cornette. In fact, Cornette's modeled his career after the King. So a little mutual admiration society, I'm sure, going on there. But Flash Funk controlling things on the left arm. Double J wants to seize the momentum of this contest. He's got to control the flow of the action. When Flash Funk controls the momentum, he controls the action. He usually comes out on top.
Flash Funk now working on Double J. You talked about the difference in Jesse James. There's a nice Irish whip reversal. Flash Funk kisses the turnbuckle. Jesse James with a dance, and there's the clothesline to knock Flash Funk down. A different Jesse James, he, I guess, tried to endear himself with the fans a few months back. Here's a cover now. There's two. Flash gets the shoulder up. However, this harder edge you talked about, and I guess trying to get himself on a winning streak, maybe using the aggressiveness toward that nature.
Let me ask you a question. You ever known a musical group where you've heard a song so much you're a little bit sick of it? You start to resent that group after a little while. You know, no matter what other music they put out, that's the one song you remember. Well, I think it's the same way with Double J.
There's a cover. There's two. Flash up again.
Double J and the fans. Fans are not letting Double J forget whenever he loses. In fact, they're saying, yeah, why don't you sing that song now? You know, and I think he's a little bit tired of hearing that. And you notice he doesn't sing the song anymore. I wonder if he resents it even being his ring music coming out to these matches we've seen him here in.
And I'll tell you what, Jesse James does not like to lose. You know, his family, the legendary Armstrong wrestling family, his father, the legendary Bullet Bob Armstrong, that family is not accustomed to losing.
No, they're certainly not. Of course, Jesse James, the youngest of the Armstrong boys, and it's a very proud family. Bullet Bob got Jesse James involved at a very young age.
Oh, Double J.
Then, of course, Double J went off to service country, United States Marine.
There's a cover. Ooh, Flash Funk gets the shoulder up again.
Served in Desert Storm, came back and started a wrestling career, took some bad advice at a young career, got away from his family, went back home, got his head together, and now looks like maybe needed to get his head together once again.
Flash Funk now taking control. Look at this. Scoop up slams Jesse James to the canvas. Double J goes 236. And now Flash Funk going where he likes to work, off the top rope. What's he going to do here now? Here he is. Drops him off the top rope. Did you see Jesse James? Flew halfway across the ring. Here's the cover now. Two, almost three. And there's Flash pointing at Jerry the King Lawler at ringside.
Well, I'm sure Lawler, more than just a little bit of a distraction to Flash Funk. Flash, I'm sure, remembering what happened in his matchup with the King's son, Brian Christopher, just a couple of weeks ago on Raw.
Here's Flash now, spinning heel kick. This could be it. He's going to cover Double J here. Two, almost three. Double J gets the right shoulder off the mat.
Boy, Flash Funk in control. Jesse James on the receiving end. Let's take another look here in the double feature. You'll see that missile drop kick off the top, Michael.
Oh.
And Double J did go flying across the ring. Flash unable to finish things off. Jesse James, a double tough customer. Don't take anything away
from him. What are you doing here? Oh, my. Across the sternum. This could be it. There's two. Oh, Double J again with the left shoulder up. Some resiliency here from Jesse James.
Flash has got to follow up. He's got Double J on the ropes. Once again, pointing and gesturing towards the King, Jerry Lawler. As Flash is going a second.
Oh, look out. What's he doing? Jerry, what are you doing? Oh, no. He just pulled Flash Funk down off the top rope. The referee didn't see it. He was distracted. And now Jesse James trying to take advantage. Oh, face first into the canvas.
Not too long ago, Double J would have let Flash Funk have the opportunity to come back up. Probably would have gone after the King. Not so anymore from Double J. Series of reversals.
Oh, no. He's setting him up. The Chartbuster. This is the Chartbuster. Oh, Flash won't get up from that. There's two and three. It's all over. Double J victorious on shotgun.
Here we go.
He's not smiling in victory anymore, Michael Cole. Double J, Jesse James, very aggressive, very assertive, but very victorious. You can't deny him that. But thanks to the King, Jerry Lawler.
I was going to say, give the assist to the King, Jerry Lawler. There's Jesse James with the victory. Still to come this week on Shotgun, the Mastodon Vader teams up with the Patriot Del Wilkes to take on those nasty Godwins from Bitters, Arkansas. It's going to be a great match.
The WWF presents the Slam of the Week.
Here comes the Patriot, and here comes the Invader. A prelude to Bad Blood in St. Louis.
UK, this is Michael Cole here with your WWF update. I'll tell you what, UK fans, this is a real treat because each week we're going to have this report getting you caught up with what's going on in the World Wrestling Federation. It is a treat exclusively for you in the UK. Well, all I can say is, wow, what an unbelievable turnout. Over 11,000 people jamming the sold-out NEC in Birmingham last week for one night only. Thank you, UK, for one of the most spectacular events in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. The first ever wrestling pay-per-view in Europe, and you made it one to remember. And what an event you witnessed, including the crowning of a new European champion, albeit in the most dubious of manners. The Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels now carries the belt, defeating the British Bulldog with a figure four leg lock. Well, this past week on Raw, Shawn Michaels was flaunting the European belt in the mecca of sports entertainment. Sold out Madison Square Garden in New York City. The place was a-rockin'. And Shawn's right. He's factually correct when he says he's the first Grand Slam winner in WWF history. The only man to ever win the World Wrestling Federation Championship, the Intercontinental Championship, the European Championship, and the Tag Team Championship. But Shawn has his work cut out for him on October 5th at WWF Bad Blood in Your House when he meets The Undertaker in a unique steel cage match. Basically, it's a chain link fence. A roof on top, it goes all the way to the floor. There's only one way in and one way out, and that's through a padlocked front door. And once you're in, you can't get out, and there's no way anyone can get in to help you out. Now, the only way to win is by submission or pinfall, and a new twist has been added. The winner will get a title shot against WWF champion Bret Hart at Survivor Series in November in Montreal. And at one point during Raw, Shawn Michaels headed for the ring carrying a steel chair. He called The Undertaker out to settle the feud once and for all. Let's take you back now to this past week on Raw for comments from the Heartbreak Kid. Stop it right there. I mean, this guy up there is unbelievable, but we are going to tell you what happened. It was a trap. As the man from the dark side walked down the ramp toward the ring, he was attacked by Hunter Hearst Helmsley, Rick Rude, China, and Shawn himself. Well, somehow, the Phenom still managed to get up after receiving plenty of punishment. He chased the quartet back to the locker room. Guess what, Shawn Michaels? There will be no escape at WWF Bad Blood. There will be no cavalry riding into your rescue in St. Louis on October 5th. Once you're locked in that steel cage, it will be just you and The Undertaker one-on-one to settle this feud once and for all. In UK, you will not be cheated out. You will see Bad Blood live on the 5th of October, live at midnight on Sky Sports 1. It is going to be an unbelievable event.
And Kevin Kelly, I'll tell you what, looks like they got a new leader.
They most certainly do. His name is Jackal. In fact, we have pre-recorded comments. The new leader of the Truth Commission.
Codename, Jackal. The plan, no less than a hostile takeover of the WWF. They say that the truth is stranger than fiction. And in the case of the missing commandant, that's very, very true. Because you see, he found out what everyone in the WWF is about to. I don't react well to authority figures. These men have been like a ship without a rudder. No more. They believe in their hearts and their minds and the plan that I've set forth. You know, the commandant used to say, the truth will hurt. That's not true. The truth will be punishing.
Kevin, the day of the Jackal, the Truth Commission has arrived, and so have DOA.
Oh, listen to this crowd.
And a total combined weight of 550 pounds, plus and change.
Will be an interesting matchup. The Truth Commission now with the Jackal have four men. DOA has four men. See what's going to happen here. Hot shot goes.
What happened to the Commandant? What is some kind of coup? A coup d'etat within the Truth Commission? Who is this Jackal? Did he serve under the Commandant? It appears that he was a member of the Truth Commission at one time. Was he excommunicated? Perhaps came in as a rogue?
Look out, Kevin. We're underway now. Here comes Recon going to work on Chains from DOA. Irish whip. Ooh, Chains catches him now with a big boot. And now Chains with a stiff clothesline. And here comes Chains going to work on Recon. Big elbow across the sternum. Again off the rope. Here's another one. Is he going to go for a third time? Yes, he is. Ooh, Recon in trouble early.
Well, it appears the Jackal isn't changing up the order. Recon always starts things off in a tag or in a six-man.
and he's finding out the hard way that Crushing Chains got a lot of momentum going into this one. I'll be interested to see what changes Jackal has for the troops of the Truth Commission.
And here's Crush now with a big right hand, knocking Recon down. Speaking of Jackal, when we saw the Commandant, he never really got involved in the matches. It's going to be interesting to see if the Jackal's going to have a, should we say, more hands-on approach with the Truth Commission. Crush misses that time, Recon getting out of the way.
Perhaps another situation for Commissioner Slaughter to try to take care of as another member of the Truth Commission now comes forward. You know, the last person I would ever want to be is Commissioner Slaughter. This man's job is getting harder and harder every week.
I agree with you, Kevin. Commissioner Slaughter has one of the toughest jobs in the world as you see Sniper now whipping Crush off the rope. Here's Crush. What a pile driver. He could cover it up right now. Here's Sniper now. He's being covered by Crush too, but he kicks out. Crush in control of this matchup. And now he's going to whip. No, there's a reversal by Sniper. Crush off the ropes now. Crush is not going to go over that easily. Here we go. Big belly to belly. Sniper in trouble. Covered by Crush. Hooks the leg. There's two. Sniper again kicks out.
Crush, the veteran of DOA. But Michael, in my opinion, Crush has never looked better in his entire career. He is at the absolute top of his game right now. He's got his brothers with him. And of course, DOA, born to ride, and they're getting set to ride all over the World Wrestling Federation.
Ooh, from behind, Recon with a big boot and a stiff clothesline that time by Sniper, and he's going to tag Recon back in. Here's Recon now working off the top rope. Double team action now by the Truth Commission. Ooh, down across the small, the back of Chains.
Taking advantage of the five count of referee Billy Silverman, that is fine tag team strategy. Doesn't appear that the change in leadership of the Truth Commission has caused this team to suffer. Recon and Sniper, much more aggressive apparently, Michael. And I think they could be on their way to victory. Would that be a surprise?
And don't forget the ace in the hole, the Interrogator, 7 foot tall, 350 plus pounds outside. There's a cover, but Chains kicks out. Hey, we would be remiss if we didn't talk about what happened on Raw this past week. Jude Love was set to meet Hunter Hearst Helmsley in a Falls Count Anywhere matchup. It wasn't Jude Love who actually was involved in that match.
No, and it wasn't Mankind either. It was somebody else, another alter ego of Mick Foley. Perhaps the first incarnation. It was Cactus Jack. Hunter Hearst Helmsley was none too pleased, but the garden came unglued when Cactus came to town.
And Kevin, as you're well aware, that match much too graphic to be shown on this broadcast.
Yeah, I think we'd get kicked off the air if we tried to show that.
It really was, as you now see Chains going to work, trying to make it to Crush, and he does, and here comes the big man from DOA. Oh, Sniper that time misses with the right hand, but Crush with the boot.
Sniper put down hard by the leader of the Disciples of Apocalypse.
What an elbow by Crush, working on Sniper now from the Truth Commission.
Jackal's looking a little itchy down in the lower right-hand portion of our screen.
Oh, across the back. Crush now in control, and look at Crush. The big man's going to go up to the top rope. What's going to happen here? Oh, no, the Jackal. The Jackal from behind. Knocking Crush off the top rope. There's the bell. The referee ends this one. He's going to give the victory to DOA. And now all four men in the ring. Jackal getting a taste of DOA and Crush. Look at this, DOA cleaning house. And the Jackal going to the Interrogator for some cover.
Crush.
Can you blame him?
Chain.
Look at that monster.
The Truth Commission disqualified this week on Shotgun. Crush and Chains from DOA pick up the victory.
Oh, they're not done, Michael. This fight's continuing.
All right, time now to check on the Intercontinental Tournament, see what's going on. And Kevin, I understand Ken Shamrock is now out of the tournament.
2 weeks ago on Raw, to secure our French colleague, Raymond Rougeau. And Michael, he's still in tip-top shape. Ray does 1,000 sit-ups a day.
Just like you.
Yeah, right. Maybe 1,000 sit-ups a lifetime. But anyway, Ray, I think, is still ready to go. And boy, what a great segment we saw earlier on. The update segment exclusively for our fans in the UK. I know it's a great way for them to keep up on all the big news and all the happenings of the World Wrestling Federation.
It really is. A lot of fun, Kevin. It's going to be called WWF Updated. It's an exclusive just for you fans in the UK. We're going to have a lot of surprises in the weeks to come, so you're going to want to stay tuned for WWF Update. Speaking of a lot of surprises, what about one night only at the sold-out Birmingham NEC? What an event.
Certainly was a huge event. I got the chance to take a look at the tape, And what a lot of controversy, especially involving Shawn Michaels and the British Bulldog. Bader and the Patriot were both on hand, as well as a tremendous sold-out crowd at the Birmingham NEC. It was a very exciting time for all of us with the World Wrestling Federation. The Godwins were there as well. I'm not too sure that the fans of the UK really appreciated Phineas and Henry, but I'll tell you what, it was a great event for all of us in the World Wrestling Federation.
I'll tell you what, we want to thank everybody in the UK for the tremendous event, for the hospitality, for showing up at the Birmingham NEC. It was unlike any other event we've ever done here in Europe in the World Wrestling Federation. We're set to go now. Bader set to lock up with Henry Godwin. And speaking of these two teams, Kevin Kelly, Bader and the Patriot will meet Bret Hart and the Bulldog in a flag match at WWF Bad Blood, and the Godwins with a huge opportunity to win the tag team titles when they hook up with the Headbangers at Bad Blood.
Well, I think the Headbangers could find out firsthand that it is easier to become champion than to stay champion. The Godwins have been title holders before, as you see Bader really laying it to Henry Godwin there. But the Patriot and Bader's challenge, quite different.
Oh.
They'll be battling lack of experience as a team, lack of a ring time as a cohesive unit. We'll see if it impacts them against Bret the Hitman Hart and the British Bulldog at Bad Blood in that very special flag match.
And this is some way to tune up for that for Bader and the Patriot as they take on the Godwins, as Phineas Godwin now gets into the ring to work on the Mastodon, the man they call Vader. And there's Uncle Cletus, the third member of the Godwin clan, outside the ring. And Phineas now with a big takedown. Vader, though, tries to back his way out of the corner and does. And here comes the Patriot, Del Wilkes.
Coming in with a series of hard left hands, the big southpaw from South Carolina, really laying it to Phineas Godwin. I'll be interested to see, Michael, if Del and Vader can put together some teamwork. They look pretty effective so far.
Really do. Here's the Patriot now with a big drop kick. Phineas outside the ring. We'll be right back on Shotgun. And Kelly, the Patriot now, trying to take control of this matchup over Phineas Godwin. Phineas now, Irish whip across the ring from Del Wilkes. Here comes the Patriot. Oh! Phineas down in a little bit of trouble. There's Uncle Cletus outside the ring.
Yeah, Cletus trying to reach his hand in there and stir the pot up a little bit. Don't be surprised if he gets himself involved in this contest.
Here we go now. The Patriot trying to set up Phineas Godwin. Can he get him over? Not that time. Ooh, nice takedown by Phineas. And now Del Wilkes feeling the pain from the Godwins.
You notice now the Godwins have cut the ring in half. They've got the Patriot in the wrong part of town.
Here now, the Patriot really needs to try to make a tag to the Mastodon, the man they call Vader, as Henry Godwin now comes into the ring. Whips the Patriot off the ropes, big elbow. Del Wilkes now in trouble. And here we go, another quick tag by the Godwins. They like to work those quick tags, Kevin, keep themselves fresh.
Well, it's the key to success as far as tag teams are concerned. And now, look at this, just sheer power.
Oh!
Dropping Dell right across the top rope, and Bader coming in. Joining with referee Mike Chioda is not going to get anything done.
And there goes Del Wilkes outside the ring. Phineas goes over to talk to Bader, and look out, Uncle Cletus is outside the ring. And here comes Henry Godwin now. Henry working on the Patriot. The Patriot felt that one in the small of the back, and now he's back in the ring. And Bader now still arguing with the referee. Fans loving the action here on Shotgun this week. It's been a great broadcast, and don't forget, Kevin, this week on Raw, the Intercontinental Tournament continues. Ahmed Johnson will meet Farouk.
Plus, I'll be interested to see what happens in the saga involving Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon. I'd be very surprised if there's a resolution to this. I know there's been a lot of bitter feelings throughout the office of the World Wrestling Federation all week long.
A jawbreaker, Del Wilkes in trouble in the corner. Henry Godwin back up again on the apron of the ring. Takedown by Phineas. Here's a quick cover. Kick out by Del Wilkes.
Notice there, it's as if they've drawn a line right across the center of the ring there. They've cut the ring in half. They've kept Del on their side. Patriots in a whole lot of trouble. Bader fresh on the apron, but unable to get in and do anything. And, if this continues like this, the Godwins will be well on their way to a hard-fought victory. Just coming up on the eve of Bad Blood, gaining momentum for their tag team title encounter against the Headbangers.
The Godwins hoping to defeat the Headbangers at Bad Blood to win the WWF Tag Team Championship for the second time. Big boot to the midsection that time of Del Wilkes. I guess it was a knee, actually, by Phineas. And here comes Henry now.
One of the few times I could think in history that the challengers for the tag team titles will go into the match as favorites. A lot of people do have the Godwins favored over the Headbangers at Bad Blood.
Body slam by Henry Godwin. Off the ropes now. Big elbow, and he misses.
And now the Patriot, Del Wilkes, going to attempt to get to Vader in the corner. Really needs to make a tag here. The Patriot, Del Wilkes, using the rope for leverage. Can Henry Godwin stop him? Yes, he does. He grabs the boot, and it doesn't look like Del Wilkes is going to get to his man, and he won't. Here comes Phineas Godwin now. The Godwins, great effort this time by tag team partners. They really know how to work inside that squared circle.
Notice after the tag was made, Henry stepped on the leg of the Patriot, preventing him to be able to slide across to Vader. Finney is now in, and the Godwins back once again in control. The Patriots been absorbing punishment for a long time.
Oh, wait a second. Sunset flip. He could get him here, but the referee out of position. There's two. Oh, almost had him. Almost had him that time.
Both Henry and Uncle Cletus provided distraction to referee Mike Chioda, slowing down the near fall there.
Uh-oh, the southpaw, the Patriot, Del Wilkes, trying to battle back. Big left hands now to Phineas Godwin. Can the Patriot make it to Vader? No, Phineas from behind. Great job by Phineas Godwin to keep the Patriot away from his partner.
What a crest of momentum ridden by the Headbangers to their tag team title win at Ground Zero. We'll see if they're able to continue that momentum. They'll be giving up size, weight, and experience to their challengers, the Godwins. Plus, the Godwins have tasted title gold before. They've come within inches of winning the title recently. The Headbangers have been facing all kinds of challenges. Matter of fact, at one time only, Los Barriquas, Savio and Miguel almost came out victorious. But I'll be interested to see if the Headbangers can indeed maintain their grasp of the tag team titles at Bad Blood. Phineas now on the
Look
second
out.
Rope.
Here's Phineas now off the rope. Oh, no. Phineas caught a boot from the Patriot in the midsection. And here comes Vader, the rested Vader, 458-pounder. Big right hand. Another one. Vader now in control. Cleaning house. A house of fire for Vader. Now he's going after Uncle Cletus. Look out from behind. Phineas almost hit Cletus, but Vader's going to get him anyway.
Oh, yeah. Vader let him have it.
Oh, no. Look out. Vader's setting him up now. The big man's going to go to the second rope. Setting him up now for the Vader bomb.
Oh, Kyle's on his feet.
Here we go. This should be it. Phineas will not get up. There's two and three. It's all over. Vader and the Patriot victorious on shotgun.
The two All-Americans will be defending the United States honoring the black match of Bad Blood against Bret the Hitman Hart and his brother-in-law, the British Bulldog. A big win for the team here, though, this week on Shotgun.
That's right. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. We're glad you could join us this week on Shotgun. Have a great week, everybody.